Sullivan Steakhouse in New York. Those are two different spots.
I was diagnosed at birth. I was in the hospital for about 6 weeks. I wasn't gaining any weight. I had high fevers. I underwent a couple surgeries, and it wasn't until 6 weeks later that a doctor, Dr. Narkowitz from Colorado, he came over and he called the doctors on the phone and he said, "Hey, this kid has cystic fibrosis." Cystic fibrosis is a life-threatening condition that affects my lungs, my pancreas, and my digestive system. So what happens is it's a buildup of mucus in the lungs and a lot of other areas in the body. So it's hard for the lungs to operate without getting treatments constantly and making the mucus break up by doing like vest therapies and stuff like that. It didn't really settle in till I was about maybe 7 years old, because up until then my parents would do everything for me, and I didn't need as much as I do now. So last year I underwent 4 or 5 surgeries and 17 hospital visits. So it was rough. It was a rough year last year, but overcoming it, you just have to keep going. You just have to let yourself get down. And it got hard. It got really hard in December. It got really tough for me. But you just have to keep going and persevere through it and know that things will get better, and it's not just going to be like this. Well, it will be like this for the rest of my life, because there's no cure right now, but it gets better. And you'll have the ups and downs just like with life, but my ups can be really great too, because it's a great feeling not coughing, or for me at least.
Well, I think we decided a long time ago that we weren't going to put a label on Elliot. We weren't going to listen to the statistics. We weren't going to just treat him as a sick kid. We decided to just treat him as a kid. And so that was really our strategy.
I think we're just very proud of the fact that he lives his life the way he does, that he wants to be involved in everything. He wants to go catch the next thing. He wants to experience so many other things, and he's got his life ahead of him, college next year, and you know, that's the next step.
Not us. We don't do anything. He's the one who really has always been in charge of his life since he was like 2 years old.
Well, golf and hockey are my two main sports, and those, they mean everything to me. They get me through the week, you know, because if I'm just not doing anything, I feel really lazy, and I feel like cystic fibrosis is getting the best of me. So I go out and play sports and hockey. I love hockey. I love my team. I love everything about hockey. I love making good saves and stuff like that. And I love golf, just going out and playing with my dad or playing with my team. And we went down to state this year. I mean, that was a huge accomplishment. So I use sports as a way to overcome everything, and sports, they're just a huge part of my life.
Fortunately, he's very active, which from a CF perspective, it's been proven that physical activity helps lung function tremendously. In fact, there was a study in Austria that showed over a 2 week period, kids were put through a boot camp type of situation, and their lung function on average improved something like 9%. And so physical activity is really, really important. So we deal with that, and he's always been very active. That's really, really important. And then diet is also very important, because CF kids have more trouble putting on weight. What he puts in his body becomes that much more important. And then of course mentally, you have to have a support system to deal with the highs and the lows of the things that you come up every day with him.
I just have to make life the best that it can possibly be, and if I can't do that, then the disease is winning, and I can't let the disease win. So I just keep going with hockey, sports, my family, my friends, going out, doing everything that a normal kid does, because I am a normal kid. I just have something that kind of gets in the way of some stuff sometimes.